One of the key ideas that we had when we, and the reason for why it is taking so long for us to actually do a sequel to BF2 in many ways, is that we felt that with the introduction of the new consoles like Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3, we needed a big new step when it comes to technology. We needed the new Frostbite engine that we developed for Bad Company 1. And by doing that, we spent all our efforts into making a game that used the whole range of power and technology in those platforms. It was quite an undertaking to go at. That was also one of the reasons why Bad Company 1 wasn't released for PC, actually, which is, of course, something we, if we could have, we would have done differently. But it was a major effort just to get it out and working. And we felt like introducing it to console only, we would wanted to make a bit of an offshoot to the franchise and not just make a sequel to BF2 at that point, since BF2 was so much with a PC-focused product. When we create a game here at DICE, we try to make sure that none of the SKUs, none of the versions of the game actually are ports. We try to give each and every one the love and care that it needs, and also listen to the specific community and fans out there of that specific platforms. Now, sometimes there's a lot of noise to cut through when it comes to when you listen to your community, but there are a lot of good ideas out there that we pick up on. And especially, like you say, the PC community is one that have special, you know, anything from special input devices in the form of mouse and keyboard to special requests and a long heritage of what they want to see. So even with Bad Company 1 and Bad Company 2, we have taken those special needs into consideration. Now, for Battlefield 3, this is going to be another step as well. I mean, we always have it looked from a dev standpoint, you have to look at one platform as being the minimum platform to stand on. But in this case, we are using PC as the main SKU, so the main version of the game, so to say. I wouldn't say that we are porting it to any other platform, because we will make sure that the other platforms will get the same kind of attention, but PC will get extra attention pretty much. Well, I think the core of what people enjoy in a multiplayer game is still the same. It's very similar. They want to go online with their friends and foes and just beat the crap out of each other in whatever way. And in the FPS genre, it's pretty much similar what it is. It's all the stuff around that changes, and you alter and you make it more accessible, and you have new platforms coming into the arena. I mean, when we started out with Battlefields, Xbox 360 was not a major multiplayer platform, and not PlayStation 3 either. Those platforms are big today. You have a core following of people that play on those, only play multiplayer on those consoles, which we of course are very happy with, Battlefield franchise being such a multiplayer focused franchise. For our studio, there's been a challenge of introducing single player, since it was a multiplayer franchise from the beginning. So the step that we took with Bad Company 1 was a big one for us. There's been other franchises, competitors, coming from the other angle, going from single player only, introducing multiplayer. Looking at the actual Battlefield franchise in itself, we are staying quite true to the core of what the game is, but also being very sensitive to listening to the signals of how does the actual competitive players out there, how do they play, what is it that they expect, and then try to marry that with the original recipe. So it's not about just churning up more of the same, it's about always refining a recipe, but not completely creating a new dish, so to say. It's just making what we have better and better and better.